my compilation reel came from a program called Gridiron Glory, which is a 30-minute high school football production that airs every Friday in the fall. It's a live production that highlights all the night's games, feature stories, coach interviews, player interviews, stats. It's kind of a sports center for Southeast Ohio football. We start the night with pretty much no content, and then throughout the end of the night, we have a live show that we put on every week. As the host, I'm in charge of interviewing coaches, controlling the pace of the show, calling highlights, interviewing the various reporters, really just kind of being the face of what is Gridiron Glory for this area. My inspiration as a journalist comes from the desire to tell stories. I think that journalism has a unique ability to connect with people, and using sports, sports is really what is my desire as a journalist, because I think that sports connects people on so many different levels, and it's really kind of a microcosm of life, and sports is an escape for so many people. And having the chance to connect individuals through the lens of sports is something that really drives me and is an inspiration for my work.
Never Forget Kiss 45 is a piece that is very important, not only to me, because for me it was an opportunity to provide an entire community with a way to honor a loved one, but for the community itself, it was a way for the family, the teammates, all of Corey's friends, the entire community of Logan was able to honor the loss of someone and also remember, even though it's a tragic death, they had a way to remember him in a positive light. The part that was most challenging with this piece is doing the interviews themselves, because you're dealing with emotion and you have to keep reminding yourself that these people are talking about the most difficult experience that they've ever been through. So for me, I was able to relate to them, and I was able to sit there and take absorb everything and feel all their emotion, but it was hard to keep myself in check, because you hear this tragedy and you want to cry for them because you feel for them. So you're relating on a personal level, but you also have to maintain the professionalism.